Hi students, welcome back to our biology classes. This is Divya Kanamili and I am going to teach you biology classes. Yes students, in the previous class we have learnt about the asexual mode of reproduction. Yes, we already learnt about one of the mode of asexual reproduction, that is vegetative propagation, in the previous class, right? Let us even learn about the other types of asexual reproduction which are there. Students, you might have heard about the organism yeast, right? Yeast is very well known in bakeries and beverage industries, where it is used for preparation of bun, bread. This yeast, it is a unicellular organism and it is microscopic. Under the microscope only we can see the yeast. So why? Because it is a unicellular organism. So now let us learn how a yeast multiplies. Yeast will multiply very fastly. So within hours it will multiply itself. How the reproduction will take place in yeast, let us learn. Okay, so to do that, let us do an activity first. So for that, we need to take a hot water. So just take hot water, lukewarm. Lukewarm means ugru bechige anta heltaralva. Yes, not too hot, not too cold. Take the lukewarm water and add few granules of yeast. So if you go for market, you can get yeast granules which are like cream color. Cream color, small small ball like structures it will be there. So take that yeast granules and mix that in the hot water whatever we have taken, and mix it properly so it will become a solution. Okay, so now take this yeast solution and add to the sugar solution. Sugar solution means take a water and mix sugar in it so that it will become a sugar solution. So add yeast solution whatever we have prepared into it. So just take one spoon of yeast solution from here to this container which is having a sugar solution. So mix it properly and place it aside for few minutes. Okay, after some time, say for example after 30 minutes, collect a drop of sugar solution whatever present here on a clean glass slide and observe this under a microscope. Okay, so when we see under the microscope, you can see the structures resembling this. So it is a general normal yeast cell. So which is a oval shape. Oval shape means egg shape. Egg yav shape irutala adana enantivi oval shape. So you can see that yeast cells are oval in shape. So this is the nucleus. Okay, so this yeast cell, we can see that after placing it into a sugar solution, after some time it will start showing the formation of a bud. So you can see, right? So the yeast is being forming a bud-like structure. So this bud-like structure, whatever is there, no, it is a developing bud, not yet completely become bud. So if you leave it as such for some more time, you can see a new bud will be formed from that. So this will be converted into a new bud. Okay. So this new bud is now detached from the parent cell. So this is a parent cell. This new bud is there, no? So this is called as daughter cell. So the daughter cell, that is the new bud, will detach. Detach means separate from the parent cell, and this new bud will act as a new individual yeast cell, and it will also grow and multiply whenever it will be getting a favorable condition and nutrition. Okay, and if you leave that as such, if you leave this procedure as such for still longer duration, you can see that these yeast cells will also, the new bud will also start multiplying and it will form few more buds. So this chain of buds will be formed. So now each bud in this chain of buds will become into a new yeast cell. Okay, so like this the yeast will multiply. So this procedure whatever we have learned till now, so it is a asexual mode of reproduction where a bud formation will take place and this bud will be converted into a new organism. Okay, so this mode of reproduction which an yeast involves is called as budding. There is one more type of asexual mode of reproduction. So this is a green color, slippery, slimy, sticky growth. So if you place your leg on that, you can slip over there. Okay, because of it is a slimy. So jaru anta gunadana irutte adike. Okay, so slimy andre no, smooth agi, sticky agi irutte. This is called as algae. So this algae There are many different types of algae. Say for about 20,000 species of algae are present. So in that one such algae is a Spirogyra. Okay. So Spirogyra, if you see here, it is having a spiral shaped chloroplast. Due to presence of spiral shaped chloroplast, it got the name Spirogyra. So always when you write Spirogyra, underline the word. Okay, because it is a scientific name. Okay, so Spirogyra, what it will do, you know, whenever it get a favorable condition, that means whenever it get a favorable nutrition and water supply, then it will start multiplying very fastly. How you know? So it will split it to fragments. So this is one fragment, this is one fragment, right? So like this, it will become into a fragment. Fragment means nothing but a piece. Okay, so it will split into a pieces and each piece now it will act as a new Spirogyra. So within a very short period of time, you can see the growth of a Spirogyra all over the place wherever a water and nutrition is available for it. Okay, so this is also one such type of a asexual mode of reproduction which a Spirogyra involves. A fragmentation, it is also a type of asexual mode of reproduction. There is one more method of asexual reproduction generally an organism involves, is a spore formation. So spore formation, to understand that, we need to understand about one more small activity. So you might have taken a bread from a bakery, right? So if you keep that bread as such in that cover itself for longer duration, say for example for week, okay, so if you forgot to eat that bread and you kept that bread as in the season. In the season means it is a winter, right? So in winter season you will be having a cold and humid environment, right? So in the season if you keep that as such in a cover itself, yes, when you open it after a week, you can see a growth, a cotton type growth over the bread. Okay, so this growth, whatever we can see on the bread, we call it as a fungus. Okay, so this fungus which is grown on that bread is called as a bread mold. A bread mold is called as rhizopus. Adra hesrenu rhizopus. The structure of a bread mold, nothing but a rhizopus. So when you see this rhizopus, it is having a head or a balloon or a bulb like structure which we call as sporangium, and it is having a tail like appearance, no? So this is called as hyphae. So it will be having large number of hyphae which is having a network like connections. Okay, so if you see that bread slice from here, you can see a cottony appearance. Cottony appearance andre cotton. Cotton alli yav riti fibers irthavala san sana dara ele tara. So ade riti idra growth kuda irutte. So if you see here, this sporangium is there, no? So it is a reproductive part. Why? Because it will produce spores. Okay, what? So spores are asexual reproductive body. Spores are produced by the sporangium. So see here, you can see, no? So this sporangium will produce these spores. So when you see these spores are very dormant in condition. Dormant means they are not going to react with the environment easily. Why? Because the spores are, so if it is a, this is a spore, the spore is covered by a hard layer. Okay, so this hard layer, what it will do, you know, it will protect the spore from the unfavorable conditions. So what are the unfavorable conditions for the spore? The unfavorable conditions are like high temperatures, low humidity, lack of nutrition. So these are the unfavorable conditions for the spore. So to protect this spore from these unfavorable conditions, yes, it is being covered by the hard cover. Okay, so whenever the spore gets a favorable conditions, what do you mean by a favorable conditions? That means it is having a low temperature and high humidity. During that time, yes, the spore will germinate and it will be converted into a new organism. Understanding? So this spore is belong to rhizopus, no? So this spore will convert itself into a rhizopus when it gets favorable condition, right? So spore, these are also a asexual reproductive bodies which we can see. So not only the fungus, mosses and ferns, yes, they also reproduce by producing the spores. So you can see a leaf like structure, no? So this is a actually a part of a fern. Okay, so when you earn, if you see the back side, see this is upper side and this is the back side, no? So this folding, whatever you can see, it is the lower part of the fern. So you can see that it is having the sori. So the black dots, whatever you can see, these are the spore forming bodies which we can see in these ferns. So these sori will produce the spores, and these spores will germinate whenever they will get a favorable condition, and a new plant, a new fern plant will be developed. Understood? So these are the some of the asexual mode of reproduction that we can see in the organisms. This is about all today's class, students. Let us meet in the next class. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel.